So what is ICL eye surgery? ICL stands for Implantable Collamer Lens and is a form of refractive eye surgery to help reduce your dependence on things like glasses and contact lenses. But what is the difference between ICL eye surgery versus LASIK? In this video, we're going to go over who makes a good candidate for ICL eye surgery and some of the pros and cons of ICL versus LASIK. Because if you're thinking of getting either of these two surgeries, you want to know your options. Let's take a look. Hey, what's up everyone? This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. And on this channel, we like to do education all about the eyes, vision products, helping you learn everything you can about the eyes, even things like refractive eye surgery. So if this is something that you really like to know about, if you are just passionate about the eyes and seeing your best, hit that subscribe button for us so you don't miss any of our future videos. Now, most people these days have at least heard of the refractive eye surgery called LASIK, which stands for laser in situ keratomelasis, and is a very fast healing refractive eye surgery that helps get rid of really the dependence on glasses and contacts. Now, another form of refractive eye surgery that's very similar to LASIK in terms of its outcome is that of the ICL eye surgery, and again stands for Implantable Collamer Lens, but is sometimes referred to as the Implantable Contact Lens, because the procedure itself is very similar to having a tiny piece of plastic, like a contact lens, inserted inside of the eye rather than a contact lens that's placed on the surface of the eye. Again, the ICL is a lens that is surgically inserted inside of the eye and placed behind the iris, the colored part of the eye, but in front of the crystalline lens, which is inside the eye. It's a very narrow space and pretty amazing that they're able to do this procedure, to say the least. Now, because the ICL is implanted inside the eye, it does have some advantages over LASIK. Some benefits of ICL eye surgery versus LASIK include the fact that ICL can correct higher amounts of myopia or nearsightedness than LASIK can. Most of the time, LASIK eye procedures can correct up to about minus 10 diopters of nearsightedness, but that highly depends on how much corneal thickness somebody has, where ICL surgery can correct to about negative 15 diopters of myopia. Another big advantage is that with LASIK, you are vaporizing tissue from the front surface of the eye. And once that's done, you can't get that tissue back. But with ICL eye surgery, because this lens is just implanted inside the eye, if something goes wrong, maybe the power changes, or for some reason they need to reverse it, they can. They can go back in, they can remove that lens, or even replace it with a different lens. So it's essentially a reversible procedure. Another big advantage of having ICL versus LASIK, and this is honestly probably why if I was gonna get a refractive procedure, I might go with the ICL versus the LASIK, and that's because with LASIK eye surgery, the most common kind of side effect or complication after that procedure is dry eyes. I already have dry eyes, so if I was gonna get LASIK, there's a good chance I would just be making things worse. But because the ICL procedure doesn't involve cutting the corneal nerves on the front surface of the eye, there's really not as high a risk as of developing complications such as dry eye disease. One last advantage that ICL has is that people tend to have less higher order aberrations than people will get with LASIK, meaning they tend to see better in low light situations, and they have reduced issues with glare and halos around lights, such as if you're driving at nighttime, people probably have better vision in those low light situations after having an ICL surgery versus the LASIK. So now that we know some of the advantages of ICL versus LASIK, who makes a good candidate for ICL? Now, I practice here in the United States, and the US FDA has approved the Vizion ICL for people of ages 21 to 45, correcting anywhere from a negative 3 diopters of nearsightedness all the way up to negative 15. And again, that is a pretty large amount of nearsightedness. But similar to LASIK, you want a stable refractive history, meaning your glasses or contact lens prescription isn't changing more than a half a diopter in any direction in the last year. Another big thing that makes somebody a good candidate for this procedure is something that doctors like myself have to measure for, and that has to be the depth of their anterior chamber. It has to be at least 3 millimeters or greater because you are implanting this lens inside the eye, and they want to make sure that there is enough space for that implant to set. Now for some good news, if you are somebody who has astigmatism, they now have approval in the United States for the Vizion Toric ICL. Which means that the new Toric ICL implant can correct from anywhere of 1 diopters of astigmatism all the way up to 4 diopters of astigmatism. Now, of course, before this new Toric ICL was available, surgeons would still be able to help people with astigmatism because they would combine both a standard Vizion ICL implant with doing LASIK for astigmatism on top of that. And I remember as a student learning in a refractive surgery suite at our school how kind of just cool that entire process was. In fact, they would do the femtosecond laser flap creation before going into the operating room to do the ICL procedure. And then later on, they would go back in and then actually use the excimer laser to create the LASIK correction for that astigmatism, which kind of seems kind of backwards. And I know this is a really high-level question, but in case there's any optometry students or ophthalmology students who are watching this and are just kind of like, why would they do it in that order? I'd love to hear your thoughts on that. Drop it in the comment section below, because again, when I was a student, I just thought it was a really cool thing. And for everyone else, if you just want to get straight to the answer of why they did that, I'll put it in a little secret text box in the video description if you want to check that out. But now that we know who the ICL eye surgery is really for, let's go over some contraindications or who is not a candidate for the ICL surgery. Again, the ICL surgery does correct for nearsightedness or myopia, and it can correct all the way up to that negative 15, but if you're somebody that is over that negative 15 or under 3 diopters, then it's probably not the best procedure for you. However, if you do have a higher prescription of myopia, let's say up to negative 20, you could still get the ICL procedure, but it's not going to probably get you to exactly zero, to the point where you don't really need glasses for distance, but you will at least reduce your dependence on getting really thick glasses. As with most refractive surgeries, if you are pregnant or nursing, you are also not a good candidate because hormones can play a change in your refractive powers as well as your tear film. And all the other contraindications for this procedure are things that eye doctors like myself really need to measure for. We have to make sure that the front angle of the front part of your eye is not too shallow. Namely, it has to be at least grade 2 or higher on gonioscopy. And your doctor also has to make sure you have enough endothelial cells on your cornea. This is the back surface of the cornea on the inside of the eye. If you don't have enough cells there, any sort of refractive procedure may increase your risk of damaging those cells, and unfortunately, you can't regrow those cells back. Again, all of those factors are things that your eye doctor, like myself, is going to look for and assess during your assessment for this procedure. Now, there are always risks for complications with any surgery, but thankfully, ICL eye surgery is considered extremely safe, and it's very rare that someone ever has a problem. But still, I do encourage you, if this is something you're considering or having any eye procedure, talk to your local eye surgeon about what's going to be best for you, as well as kind of any complications or concerns that they may have for you in your eyes. So finally, what are your thoughts and experiences with either ICL or LASIK? If you have a friend, a family member, or yourself have gone through either of these procedures, let us know your thoughts and overall experiences in the comment section below. Otherwise, if you've learned something new today, hit that like button for us and subscribe to the channel if you are new. If you want to learn more about LASIK eye surgery or other forms of refractive surgery, check out other videos that we've made up over here to the side. Or if you'd like to learn something else that's cool about the eyes, go ahead and click or tap the screen down over here. Again, this is Dr. Allen. Thanks so much for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.